As Esther is standing before you, allowing us to express to you through her process, she has managed through a few years of meditation and many years of doing this, and through coming into alignment even now as she is standing here, she has managed to bring her vibration into the frequency that is us so that we are one in this moment. Esther is not dead in this moment. She's not gone to some other galaxy. She is not timed out. She is not sleeping under the stage. Esther is blended with that which is Abraham, and you are experiencing the benefit of that blending. And you don't need Esther to experience that blending, for each of you has access to that same non-physical stream of consciousness. We express ourselves as Abraham because we wanted to be first in the phone book. Just kidding. We express ourselves as Abraham because as Esther is receiving the block of thought that explains that which we are, she is not hearing words. We don't whisper words into her ear that she repeats. We offer knowing that she translates at an unconscious level and expresses into the equivalent that best matches it. So over time, as we give her an impulse of thought, she is able to not only translate the thought, translate the meaning into something that is meaningful for most of you, into the language that she understands. But she is also able to feel the intent with which we offer it. So the personality that you know as Abraham is a specific translation from Esther's understanding of the vibration that she is receiving. And all of you have the ability to do that. You are all short-selling yourself and living but a shadow of life that is you when you do not take the time to manage the vibration that is you and bring it into the equivalency of who you really are. When you are in your most joyous moment, you are blended between you and you. When you are in your most irritated moment, you have separated yourself from who you are. As the equipment was malfunctioning this morning, some sort of bugaboo in Esther's microphone, Esther felt herself beginning to tremble because this matters to her, and she was focused upon what has gone wrong, what will we do, what will happen. And as Jerry and Karen and Mike sort of gather round, and Karen softly explains that there are about 15 different ways that they can make this work. It doesn't have to come through this one little cord. Esther's trembling stopped and she began coming back into her body. And we want you to understand that every day, all day, you have those options. You can focus upon things that separate you from the confidence and the security that is you, or you can come back into alignment. There is nothing magical going on here other than a demonstration of practiced alignment with source energy, which all of you are doing and not doing, but few of you are doing deliberately. In the beginning of our interaction with Jerry and Esther, Jerry asked endless questions, still does. Now he's happy that you have added to the list of questions. There is nothing that we would rather do, and we are including those of us who are non-physically focused and that which is Jerry and Esther. There is nothing more satisfying in all of the universe for any of us than to be in an environment like this with you who have been living your lives, who are specifically focused upon the time-space reality in which you are living, who have been selecting and sifting through the data of life and who have come to conclusions about what you want, who are here because you want to figure out effective, succinct, easy to understand and apply ways of closing the gap between the vibration that is the habit of thought that you've been thinking. It's what your beliefs are. Beliefs, just a thought you keep thinking. And mostly you just keep thinking it. We love you very much because you're lazy. In other words, it is easier to think the same thought that you've been thinking. It is easier to go along with what others think. It is easier to believe in sickness in your environment today than to believe in wellness because you are force-fed information constantly about the sickness of your body. Most of you, when you think of your long-range plans relative to health, you are envisioning and telling the story of tubes up your nose in the end. That can be the only reason that you are panicked over the idea of not having health care. Healthcare costs have gone through the roof. No one in their right mind or under normal conditions could begin to pay for what most of you believe is coming down the road. You do not, as humans, believe in the well-being of your physical bodies. And the reason that you don't believe in the well-being of your physical bodies is because you've trained yourself to look at what could go wrong, instead of reaching for the vibration of the source within you, who knows that well-being is the order of your day. It is the order of the universe. It is the legacy that you have inherited. It is the promise of your future. It's who you are. Well-being is the dominant factor in all that is. Now, because you are free will beings, you have the ability to focus wherever you want. You can focus upon what is wanted or lack of it. You can make the best of something or the worst of something. You can worry and fret, or you can look for reasons to feel good. You can compliment people or criticize them. You can complain, or you can reach for positive aspects. You have those options all day, every day, but you're not likely to do something very different from what you've been practicing. Because what you've been practicing, because of law of attraction, is what is most dominant in your vibration. So, a thought that you think causes you to offer a vibration. And when you offer a vibration because of the thought that you're thinking, law of attraction responds to that thought soon enough, not immediately, but soon enough, within seconds, within 17 seconds. The thought that you're thinking then begins to bring other thoughts of vibrational equivalency to it. When you get focused upon a thought and you begin to let that thought be something that is often thought, a sort of chronic thought, the place you always go. You know how when somebody brings up that person you've never liked, and as soon as you hear the name or even think about that person in some way, you immediately go to your pre-decided, predetermined, well-practiced thought, chronic thought, belief about that person. And what we want you to begin to understand is you don't have to do that, nor is it a good idea to do that, because, bless your hearts, you've picked up all kinds of thoughts that serve you, but you've picked up all kinds of thoughts that don't serve you. So we want to help you to decipher this arena of thought and understand that there is a thought that you think that is just a thought that you think. It's not a very important thing. You're just thinking this thought, unless you think this thought a little longer. And as you think that thought a little longer, until another thought has joined it, and another, and another, and another, and another, soon this thought that you're thinking is not only a thought, it becomes a chronic thought, or you could say a dominant thought. Once you have trained yourself into a thought to the point that we are calling it dominant and you might call it belief, now law of attraction is responding to that, and you can't create outside of that vibrational patterning. You just can't do it. You can't practice thoughts and set up that vibrational patterning within yourself and expect law of attraction to make you the exception to law of attraction. Law of attraction is responding to how you think. And an easier way for you to hear it is law of attraction is responding to how you feel about everything. How you feel about everything is what you're living.